It feel like I'm underwater in this motherfucker. What the fuck going on? I know, very white voice. If you got a fat boyfriend, he make you suck a dick. He just put his stomach all on your shit. Smother you with the stomach and dick. Bitch, you suck stomach. Don't suck the nigga navel till it got hard. Bitch, you got problems. Sometimes I be thinking my life fucked up, and I go on the internet and be like, damn, just do it. What is that sound in your throat, you big throat bitch? What is that? Is that like snicker juice in your throat? Call the fat bitch, what you doing?
I ain't doing nothing. I'm cooking.
That's how they sleep too. You be like, damn, bitch, this bitch about to die. She wake up, you have your clothes on. Like, bitch, I'm about to get the fuck out of here. Retribution with the bitch. Shout out to the white girls in there. I like the white girls too. White girls in the building. White girls suck your dick and buy you a PlayStation 5 with 3 games the same day. You fall in love with this bitch in a week. You hear me? Take the white bitch to your mama house. Look, ma, I know she white. I know you hate with the white devil, all that, da, da, da. But this bitch here. I know you Muslim, ma, but listen, this white girl. Huh? You got a free
roll? I can roll.
She is not the devil. In the car. Suck some dick. Dicks do not suck themselves, ladies. I'm just saying. Fellas, your dick ever been so hard and shiny at the top? You'd be like, what the fuck? What's wrong with me? My dick's shiny at the top. Jesus. You be in the bathroom like, man. Trying to wait till that motherfucker go down. You ever took the perk and it didn't work? You still came fast? You like, damn, nigga, I spent $50 on that motherfucker. I thought this was supposed to make you come fast. I mean, you get it. You get it. Come on. I think, y'all, listen, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and, damn.
It's something in
there. I wish I sounded like that for real. And then next year, you know, I'm about to go, but next year is a whole different year, so just start your whole shit over, man. Fuck that shit. Anything happen this year, that shit over with. Next year, I don't give a fuck if AT&T call you and say, listen, you didn't pay your bill for December. Listen, baby, that was last year. I changed over a new leaf. I suggest your punk ass do the same thing. And block this number, bitch. Stop calling here. Pay my shit when I want to. That's why I'm going to get, what's that? Hello. What's that one called? Metro, PCS. Okay. Get Metro. All right, I'm out of here. Thank y'all. I'm about to go.
Like this one, there's seats available, but I can't get one. And somebody just act like they working for Weight Watchers and jump up and like, hey, bro, you need a seat? You need something like you want to sit down? That's that fat. I don't want to. These knees still work. You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Got to, man. See, I want to be the fat that all the ladies love, you know? Like to cuddle with, you know?
Yeah.
What the ladies like to cuddle with the big guys that clap it up. Okay, yeah. Not as much as I expected, but we gonna keep it going with it. Yeah, I want to be that fat. That's the fat I want to be, that I can cuddle with, you know? Sitting there listening to all her problems and everything, you sitting there rubbing on her thigh. Yeah, she rubbing on your stomach. Yeah, that's how we do it, you know? I just want to be healthy, you know what I'm saying? That's what it's all about, right? Being healthy. You gotta take the sea moss. You gotta take the black seed oil.
Yeah.
You gotta take your men's health. Good for the prostate, fellas. Mm-hmm. Remember I used to shoot? You know, shit dribble now? Yeah, you gotta get the pills. You gotta get those pills for your prostate. I ain't never think I'd be that old. I'm talking about prostates. Like the 18-year-old me would never even thought about this shit. You know what I'm saying? This is crazy. The future is here. Clap it up for the future.
Woo!
Alright. Future. Shit is getting insane though. They programming us, you know what I'm saying? Like, fellas, you ever go to the bathroom and take a piss? Have a little gas and you left your phone on the bed though, and then you think, I gotta take a shit now. And you sit down and take a shit. This is the most unhappy shit, the most boring shit you ever take in life without your cell phone.
Right.
You thought about it, like, we gotta have our cell phones with us. Cause back in the day, what we do, you know, black people, when you went in y'all bathroom, what did y'all have for the entertainment in there? You had Jet and Ebony. Jet, oh damn, y'all was broken homes. Y'all have Jet and Ebony? This joke ain't gonna work with these motherfuckers. They're like, we had Jet and Ebony. That's what we read. You know, you read. You know, I don't know what white people had. Well, maybe the stocks or some shit. I don't know. Gotta get it in to get these NFTs. You know, that type of shit is going on.
Right.
Hey, you gotta have that phone. If you forget your phone, it's just like, taking shit is not so good. It's like, even when you scroll on TikTok, it don't even seem as good. You know what I'm saying? It's just like, TikTok is definitely not good today. If you get your phone, that shit is crazy, I'm telling you. But if you really want to scare the shit out of you, if you're being constipated, get on TikTok at like 11 o'clock at night. Turn all the lights off and get on TikTok. All the shit is going on. The world is flat. Everybody getting cloned. If that don't scare the shit out of you, I don't know what will if you constipated. That shit is insane. You know? I want to tell y'all one thing. I'm happy to be here. You know why? I just got a job.
Yeah.
I don't know how long I'm going to keep this motherfucker, though. Did just get a job, you know? It seemed like I got fired from like every job I ever had in my life. You know?
You ain't
got
to stand for this?
I got fired from a job one time. My mom was my boss. Yeah. That Thanksgiving turkey does not taste like the same after
the regular, like this regular stance like these. I just hope.
Fucking these all the way up, you know?
Oh, wait, no.
Where the couples at? Make some noise. Couples, make some noise.
Usually I hold it and walk around and it don't bounce.
All right, all right. I didn't bring it. Why does shit sound like it's auto-tuned? Kanye West. Like Kanye West up, man. All the couples, I'm glad to see y'all together, you know what I'm saying? If you've been together with your mate over 3 years, clap it up, clap it up. 4 years, 5 years.
Damn.
If you just met your girl tonight. shit, nobody's clapping. What the fuck is going on here? Man, Jackpot, he be clapping it up, you know. He'll clap it up for how long y'all been together? Okay, cool, that nobody cares. Okay, listen. No, 7 years. No. But see, the good thing is, couples that stay together over 2 or 3 years, y'all only stay together. It's not because it's love. It's not. Love ain't shit. You can't, it's secrets. You can't let that lady go out there in the world after breaking up with you, knowing all the freaky shit you into. You know what I'm saying? It's secrets. Because when you with them, you the freakiest motherfucker in life. Soon as you break up, you'll see her standing there with her friends at the club, and she be like, bitch, ain't that dude you used to piss on right there?
Hey, yo.
Okay, a few motherfuckers that got pissed on. I like that. Yeah, that's my type of crowd, okay? Nasty motherfuckers. Hey, how you doing, internet world, wherever you watching us from? I don't know. All 29 of you motherfuckers, I appreciate it. Man. Thanks for buying those tickets.
Hey.
I am from Chicago, Illinois. Anybody from the Midwest? Once again, anybody from Chicago? Chicago. Sorry, keyword was Chicago. I like Vegas people, man, but you definitely tell when a motherfucker born and raised here in Vegas. I don't, I'm just saying. I was at the loctician getting my locks done. Not now, this is back when it was fresh. But this dude walked in, he had Nevada on his face. Had a gang of tattoos and had Nevada on his face. I'm standing out there, I'm smoking. He just walked up, it's like, yeah, I'm from Las Vegas, Nevada, born and raised. And then just went in. I didn't even ask him a question. He just offered that info about him being from Las Vegas. I said, yeah, I could tell. You got the whole thing on your face right there, bro. I could tell. Good job. Good job. But you definitely can tell. I'm telling you, it's something about it. You can tell where people's from pretty much when you talk to them, though. You can tell a LA person or a Cali person, a Midwest or East Coast person. It's just Vegas people. They can be your friend, and next you know, they may be tying your ass up. You don't know. And,
right.
Maybe utilizing that Lake Mead, that good old Lake Mead.
Good old Lake Mead.
A lot of motherfuckers been found in Lake Mead. I heard they had an underground bum fight thing going on out here in Vegas. That's big. Did y'all know about that?
Hell yeah.
See, look at this shit. Las Vegas, the land of bums that fight. For nothing. Nobody wins. It's not even a prize. It's not even a jackpot, if you do say, as a joke to boom, boom.
They gave him a rock. They gave him crack rocks.
I got to do this type of shit. No, that's, bro, it gets better. Don't worry about it. But it's like, why are these bums fighting? Like,
for the
shopping cart that wheel doesn't turn side to side every time you push it or squeak? I mean, what's really going on? Like, the police told us. He said, listen, do not go over there. We had got a flat tire, and then police was coming. They seen three niggas, so they had to stop. So, racism. Where are we at without racism? Yeah, you gotta have racism. But anyway, I'll do that joke in a second. But yeah, so the police officer told us, while helping us fix the car, do not go down there. It's a land of bums that fight, and they have weapons. And I was like, if you the police, you know this, you have to stop this shit. You know, he's like, shit, I be gambling on the motherfuckers, so
right.
Welcome to Las Vegas, you know? Brenda, I thought we was co-hosting this shit. You playing solitaire and walking around and shit. What's really going on? Candy Crush and shit. You know, he knows what I do, you know, but
just keep going.
Right. Okay, hit the music. Are you really still doing that? Hey, internet people, we doing jokes and shit. We got a lot of artists gonna come up. We got people who gonna break dance and all kind of shit. Who break dance? Raise your hand if you gonna break dance for the crew tonight. I should go back to my old days when I was break dancing back in 85.
Powerhouse.
It was cold. Chicago break dancing on that cardboard.
Right.
Yeah. At one time, I hurt my neck and I had that neck brace for 6 months. I think I'll stop doing that.
I could break dance, but
maybe
it's
not for the heavy nigga to do, you know. Maybe I should slow down. Hey, welcome. Come on in. How we doing? Try the catfish. It's excellent. How you doing? All right.
What?
When I tell people that I'm from Chicago and they always have that, probably never been to Chicago, they always have questions like, is Chicago is as bad as it seems? And it's actually worse. Worse than it seems, because you know, because a lot of times shit don't get reported, like on the television or news channels or anything like that, or in the paper.
I got fired after doing a blowjob.
Oh, wow.
Okay, what? I'm gonna stop my set.
What?
For a second. You're a little more exciting. You talking about.
Hold on. I gotta get this. Hold on.
Oh, well.
What was that, Miss Lee?
What you said?
I got so many questions, like.
What she said again?
Fuck my joke. How did you get the job? Like, didn't you do the blowjob first? Or did you just do real good that time and then just fell back? She don't even know the camera on. She just talking. How did that time? I got fired from Sunny Day. All right. I ain't cuff his balls long enough. He said, go ahead, Lisa. She give you that cotton candy blowjob. You see, like, hey, what's that? You picking shit off of it. Damn, girl, you're doing good. Cotton candy blowjob. Hey, baby, put that cotton candy wig on and come holler at my mans in there. Be like, damn, girl, I'm about to cut them off this cotton candy already. So much sugar in it. She know what she's doing. That make your nuts sweet for her. That's what it is. She, cotton candy wigs coming to a beauty supply near you.
I guess you have been accosted enough, and y'all give it up for Tino Terrell. Yeah.
Y'all drinking from the bar?
Yeah.
Make sure you get some. Hyatt ass drinks.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Motherfucking water costs $5. I bought a beer for $6, so. Shit, oh man, I'm a hood nigga though. So we gonna talk about roaches. Y'all got roaches in y'all house? Hey, so no, check it. I moved to Sumner, right?
Yeah.
And I got this nice ass crib. I know. I mean, everything is nice in it, you know what I'm saying? Nice walls, nice, you know, furniture and shit, you know, nice bathroom. But the motherfucker got roaches. And I figured, you know, the $2,000 I pay a month, I wouldn't get roaches. It's fucked up, man. I was in a bathroom one day, sitting on the toilet playing Candy Crush. How many of you people still play Candy Crush? And because I need some lives. I'm on board like 2022. You know what I'm saying? I'm sitting on the toilet, man, playing Candy Crush. Is it an echo? That's what it's gonna sound like? I'm gonna repeat myself? Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah, I guess. I don't know if I get used to that. But, I'm sitting on the toilet, man, playing Candy Crush, man. And I was in the middle of a time board. And all of a sudden, out of the corner of my eye, my peripheral, I see a roach come out the corner. And I'm like, oh, shit, man. Now I gotta try to kill this roach and playing Candy Crush. It's bullshit. But you know how roaches play with you, man. They come a little close, then they run away, then they come a little close. So, you know, I had to pull my leg up out of my pants. You know what I'm saying? I tried to step on this motherfucker, man. Anyway, I lost the game of Candy Crush, though, so fuck it. I ate a roach one day, though. Yeah, man, I had made nuts. I'm a fat dude. You know what I'm saying? I got titties and all that. Perky ones, too. And I made a fresh motherfucker tuna sandwich with potato chips and Lay's, too. The real shit. And a motherfucking roach climbed up in my tuna sandwich, nigga. I was like, fuck it, you gonna go down with the tuna. Roaches taste pretty good, though. They are. They get protein. I can't stand a broken toilet seat. It's always the left side that breaks. Yeah, it is always the left side. You know what I'm saying? Like, in my bathroom, the toilet seat is in the middle of the tub and the fucking washer thing, the sink. And it's fucked up and I'm a big dude. So you know what I'm saying? I sit on the toilet and I gotta put my leg in the tub and I gotta lean on the motherfucking sink. You know what I'm saying? I gotta get that motherfucking, that sink little, damn, what the fuck is called? I'm high. Fuck it, I don't know. But yeah, I can't stand that. I can't, but you know what I'm saying? About the broken toilet seat, it's like when you don't know it's broke, and then you lift up to go wipe your ass and you fall right in the tub. Yeah, it's fucked up. I like big bitches. I like the ones that always carry the hot sauce in their purse. Because you can always count on fat people to always have good decisions on where to go to eat. You know what I'm saying? I do the tour of Vegas a lot. That's Denny's, IHOP, McDonald's, Wendy's, sometimes Popeyes. You like Popeyes?
Yeah.
Yeah, man, Popeyes pretty good, man. Yeah, Yeah, they chicken tenders, fine as fuck. The number four, the four-piece chicken tender with the beans and rice and fries. Yeah, that's my shit. My shit is Denny's, though. I love the fuck out of Denny's. I don't know. I think I love them because they cheapness, man. It's like, you know, they got the little 2, 4, 6, 8 menu. Well, they ain't got it now. They took that out. They did, yeah. You go to Denny's, too. Yeah, y'all go to Denny's, too. But, yeah, Denny's be having the greatest food, man. They my favorite dish is the salmon cob salad, and the salmon dinner. The salmon dinner is $17.99, to let you know. Because I know prices too, you know. Then Wendy's, you know, only thing I'm mad about Wendy's is that they went up a dollar on their biggie bag now. It's like $6 now, man. It was $5. Now it's $6 for the biggie bag. Or you can get the number one, which is the chicken sandwich. Or you can get the number two, which is double baconator. Oh, yes. Number three is the triple baconator. I mean, I know the motherfucking menu, dog. Not saying that I frequent there a lot, you know. I just know food. Like, I'm the type of nigga, like, I weigh my food when I get it. Like, I would be at a restaurant, you know, they bring out the little 4 ounces of meat. I pick up all that meat and weigh it. That ain't 4 ounces, dog. You owe me like 2 more ounces of motherfucking steak. I'm not gonna pay $50 for a half an ounce of steak. That's all I'm saying. I would show you my titties, but I got a sweater on. No, you don't wanna see my titties? All right. I was gonna give you some beads. All right.
Yo, what's up, Vegas? I came from Seattle for this shit, so y'all better have a fucking good time, all right? So, my name's Dante. Yeah, it's spelled all fucked up, though. Yeah, it's D-U-A-N-T-E. So I get everything from Duante to Duant. I even get Dwayne once in a while, like the T silent and shit. Worst part for me is when I go to a new job, people have the balls to ask me if I spell my name right. Like, I didn't graduate kindergarten and shit, right? And then I figured out my name's too ethnic for my resume. Yeah, I got a master's degree, and the only calls I get for jobs are like liquor store manager, garbage man, security. So I decided to go by my middle name, right? It's Edward. Yeah, calls got way better. I got calls for like IT, management, financials. One problem, we get to the interview, they're looking for a Duante. Sorry, they're looking for an Edward, and they got a Duante, if you know what I mean, right? And I know white people think we're the only ones with fucked up names. That's not true. Went to the doctor's office, read the girl's name tag. It was G-A-N-E-L-L. So I told her, that's a beautiful way to spell Janelle. And she said, no, sir. My name's Anel. Yeah, I said Anel with a G, right? She's like, that's inappropriate. And I was like, bitch, I'm just trying to remember your name, shit. And then being mixed is weird because people mistake my culture. Had a white lady come up to me and go, aren't you one of those Samoas?
She needs to screenshot this conversation.
And I was like, no, ma'am. I'm not a Girl Scout cookie. And if I'm a cultural cookie, I'm an Oreo. Bitch, get it right. You know what I'm saying? Double stuff thanks to COVID. Anybody else talk about? And then I think the worst part about being mixed is you ever been called the wrong racial slur at the wrong time? I'm not saying there's a right time, but there's definitely a wrong time, right? Shit. But I remember the first time I was called nigga. It was by my mom. Yeah, we were at a barbecue. I was like, who brought this white lady? She's probably the one who brought the potato salad with the raisins in it, you know what I'm saying? Then I had to whisper at her, I'll meet y'all back when this is over, shit. And then I did my 23andMe to figure out what I was, because I'm all racially ambiguous and shit, right? And the results have been fucking with my personal identity. But let me stop there. I'm tired of white girls doing their 23andMe. Yeah, I don't want to hear about how they're 5% black and they got a big butt and they know how to dance, you know what I'm saying? Not only that, I'm kind of jealous because my black didn't kick in. I can't dance for shit, you know what I'm saying? Don't worry though, my white did, ladies. I got good credit. be the first Dante with a car and a house in my name. You know what I'm saying? Shit. But I got the results back, right? It's been fucking with my personal identity. And this whole time they told me I was an angry black guy. Gonna find out I'm 60% white. Yeah, I guess I'm an angry white guy, right? Here's the worst part though. I try to go to one of their meetings. Yeah, they wouldn't let me in. I had a sheet on and everything. I was like, how'd you guys know? Shit. There's a guy at the door talking about there's no teens Wayne, you idiot. You know what I'm saying? And then I like to fight stereotypes. I actually used to be an IT teacher, but I don't quite fit the description. So my first week of class, my white students would heckle me. They'd say shit like, the floor's been swept, the garbage's been taken out. Don't worry, I found a way to get back at them. Since I have a master's degree, I tell all white students to call me master.
Oh my God!
Yeah, I tell them that's their black history joke of the month, a little late just like us, right? Best part is, if any white people didn't like that joke, let me give you a little history lesson. We didn't like it either, right? And then I was a pretty good college teacher. So I always get that same question. People are like, why don't you teach high school or middle school or elementary school? And I'm like, there's one reason. Yeah, it's quite simple. I like to fuck my students, and that's kind of fun at those other institutions, shit. Hey, they're community college students. They need extra credit to graduate. Fuck you guys, shit. I'm just trying to offer extra credit opportunities, shit. Oh, that got the white girl's attention, don't worry. I'll help you get your AA, baby, what's up? But if you can't tell, I'm not really made for an office job. I'm from Seattle and everybody's all passive aggressive. And I'm more like aggressive aggressive. Yeah, like I won't do a subliminal Facebook post or email to the boss. If you piss me off, I'll just catch you by the Keurig and punch you in the throat. And then not only that, but you always get a project with somebody you hate. Last month, I got a project with Bob. Bob's a racist. Bob hates me. I hate Bob. Yeah. Fuck Bob, right? Everybody was like, well, what are you going to do about that project? I was like, I'm not doing shit. They're like, you're not worried about getting fired? I was like, no. I'm the affirmative action hire. Bob better figure that shit out, right? Might be part of why Bob's mad. Totally different qualifications. Same pay. Fuck Bob. Shit. And then not only that, as a minority, I hate having an office job because we always do a potluck. And I always get white coworkers that want to make an ethnic dish for me. And I'm like, I don't do that shit to you guys. I don't bring green bean casserole or stovetop stuffing to the event, right? But the worst part is, the day of, Megan will come up to me. And she'll be like, you gotta try these greens. Yeah, I bet you they're better than your mom's. Yeah, and I'm like, bitch, that's disrespectful. Yeah, my mom's white. I don't want to take up too much more stage time. How much can I do more? A couple more minutes? Fuck, she ain't listening. Never mind.
3, 2, 1.
Oh, no, I'm going to do another one then. So I'll end on this. I'm going to end on a dark joke. I feel like when life's going bad, people always do it, say anecdotal shit to cheer you up. Like, just because you have all your arms and legs doesn't mean life's going good, right?
Right.
So I remember when my mom passed away. Everybody wanted to cheer me up. They're like, you should get a necklace or earrings or maybe a little pendant. That way you'll have something on you to remind you of her. And I was like, oh, that's sweet. You mean like these cigarette burn scars? Best part is, there's a tobacco usage history with these, because on the right hand, that's a Salem. That's a full menthol cigarette. And later, she became a classy lady, so on the left hand, it's a Virginia Slim. Don't worry, if this joke's too dark for you, I got my revenge. Because when the bitch died, I had her cremated. Guess who's the ashtray now, mom? Shit! Think I got the better burn out of that one, right? Best part is, first time I told that joke, the guy in the front row laughed, cried with a scar on his forehead, and was like, I miss you, Dad. Hey, thank you for having me, Patio. Give it up for Sauce in the City, Brenda Brown!
One, two, three. Burning wake up!
Get over here.
Damn, it was only a dream. You're not Jeff Dunham.
Hey, wait a minute. You're not Triumph the Insult Dog either.
Oh yeah, where is he? I'll fix his nut-looking ass. Why, that ball breath bastard stole my cigar and my hat.
All right, Bernie, settle down.
Oh yeah, I'm telling you, he's a coyote and I'm a roadrunner. I'm gonna swoop and poop on him.
Now listen, this is a lovely audience here for you to perform for. Look at all these beautiful ladies here.
Aye, ladies. Aye, ladies. Are you here to laugh? I can't hear you. Are you here to laugh? Can I tickle your asses with a feather?
What?
I said particularly nasty weather.
All right, now you apologize to these ladies. In fact, her boyfriend's gonna kick your butt.
He's a queer.
What?
I said he drinks light beer. And I saw him in the men's room. He's got a real big thing.
What?
He's got a $100 bill tattooed on the end of it.
Bernie, you're telling me this man right here's got a $100 bill tattooed on the end of his thing?
Yeah, Joe does.
What, you know Joe?
That's Mr. King. And he's got a $100 bill tattooed on the end of his thing. And
So in Las Vegas, I have been doing photography, stage production, and the entertainment industry for about 25 years now. And it is my gift from God to the world. However, it is not my way of surviving in it. So, of course, I drive an 18-wheeler. What else do you do when you're a bad bitch? That does take a special kind of person to drive an 18-wheeler. You're by yourself in a box of wheels for about all day, all night, all day, all night. White line, white line, white line, white line. I don't mind the solitary though. Now, for those of you that have not been to jail, solitary means I'm by my motherfucking self. And that's okay because I like to get to know my 12 other personalities.
Here.
Basically, I'm going to introduce you to a few of them tonight. We don't have time for all of them. So the first one likes to come out when it's all foggy and dark and scary out. You know, as I call her the scary bitch. You know, she also likes to come out when it's really fucking windy and my trailer's bouncing back and forth. And really, really scary.
You better be funny out this motherfucker. Shout out to garbage comics in the world.
Yeah.
Hell yeah, give the motherfuckers love. There's none here tonight, but if you give it money, I'm a garbage comic. I'll take your dollars. Well, I've been thinking real hard about some things I'm gonna change in my life in 2023, and one of them is I'm gonna divorce my wife and I'm gonna get remarried. Yeah, I'm gonna leave that bitch. Fuck yeah, quit too. I'm not even gonna give her I'm gonna give her papers the fucking janky way too. I'm gonna put her in the mail. And then just go on my life. Like put them in our mailbox, myself. Not put them in the mail, just in the mail. And go on my life. That's it. She'll figure it out. She knows when it's signed. They'll be marked with yellow tabs. And then by Tuesday, I'm gonna remarry. Yeah. To a fella. Yeah. Thought about it, I really thought about it. This is something I really thought about. I thought about it. Marriage is a business contract. I don't need to really like the person I'm in business with. What? Business ain't going so good. Business contract needs to be renewed. So I figured I'd just burn off that half of the company and just start with some new shit. Thought about it. I really thought about this shit. Because when you're married, see, I've been married, this will be my second time. Yeah, I ain't running the first one. Your insurance gets cheaper. Mortgages are easier to get. It's almost as easy as white people, but not quite.
Right.
All right? Like, sir, by yourself, forget about it. Together, maybe. You understand what I'm saying there? So, yeah. So, just need the contract. You don't really need her. Just some bills and shit. So I ain't gotta fuck the nigga.
Oh, hell no.
I ain't gotta fuck him. You just need a nigga to split some bills with me and shit. Split this motherfucking mortgage and shit. Keep my car insurance low on this motherfucker and shit. Be the nigga that bail me out when I let my tickets get too high. That type of shit. That's what I need this nigga in my life for. You know?
What's the benefit of being with your ass?
I'm about to have a half of the bills, nigga. What the fuck? See? That's why I'm marrying a nigga. You see how difficult she just made that shit? I'm marrying a nigga. That's why. Because a nigga be like, as long as you got the other half, cuz. Yes, cuz. I got the other half. All right, damn nigga, shit. I'm going to go play ball with Jimmy and then peace, cuz. You know what I'm saying? He's going to be out. I'm going to grab the sticks. I'm going to hit up my other niggas and be like, what y'all doing later? You know, that's what's going to happen. And he's not going to give a fuck that I'm hanging out with my other homeboys and shit. Because as real niggas know, homeboys of other homeboys don't really mix. Girls don't get that. Just because that's your dude, he don't want to be friends with your homegirl's dude. Actually, secretly, we hate that nigga. You know why we hate that nigga? Because he know bullshit about you, because your girlfriend don't know how to keep her fucking mouth closed, and he can't even tell this nigga. Fuck that nigga. I don't even want to play Dungeons and Dragons with this nigga, because he got secrets I can't have. Because if he tell me, his relationship's over. I hate him because he's smart. But two niggas together, not fucking, just splitting bills? What? Who the fuck cares who you gonna play basketball with, nigga? Just have your half of the bills. It's all you gotta have. And a picture or two of the house of you guys together. This research, they'll come check. The insurance people will come check and be like, you seem awfully manly to be married to another man. You see the other nigga. Kids are wondering, no, I'm not gonna marry no bitch type nigga neither. Fuck that. I need a nigga that's gonna protect me out in these streets. He can't just fucking provide his half. He gotta protect the nigga out here. Dude, I might need him to spin the motherfucking block, like the kids say. I might need that out my nigga. I need me a nigga that 5 minutes out of jail is what I'm saying. 5 minutes out of jail. He can have all the felonies he want. My credit great. I got a good job. I got benefits that'll cover me and him. All I gotta do is get married to this nigga and that shit goes from 200 to 100. Boom. Every now and then let him touch my booty.
Oh,
no. He a jail nigga. What am I saying? No? And get stabbed in the shower? That's stupid. The fuck? He got his half of the bills, I got my half of the bills, he protecting the nigga and shit. All I gotta do is let him just like every now and then just let him, ooh, nigga, I'm cool with that shit. I'm a nigga, I'm a man out here. Shit. Fuck yeah, nigga, we out here like this. Nigga, I need me a big nigga too, cause I'm not small. What if I fall and twist my ankle? I need a nigga to get me to the car. Somebody, I'm sorry, bro, no disrespect. You couldn't do it. I'd be laughing. You'd be like, bro, I'll be back with the paramedics.
When I say this, you say diva, man.
Diva, man. Diva.
Oh, my God, hell, me. Oh, the fuck are you?
Come on. When I say man, y'all say diva, man.
Diva.
Yes.
Diva.
I know one thing. It's colder than a motherfucker in this motherfucker. I've been in this bitch since 8 o'clock. I love Brenda. Y'all give it up to Brenda. She done froze the shit out of me, goddammit. I got icicles on my ass cheeks. How y'all doing today? My name is Miss Diva. I'm from Detroit, Michigan. Any Detroiters in the building? Shut the fuck up. We outnumbered again, motherfucker. Look here, y'all. Miss Diva wound up. I've been in Vegas 5 years. I come in this mother, the streetlight so long, I can bust two nuts in that motherfucker. I was at the streetlight so motherfucking long, I reached over and asked the motherfucker to give me some. Y'all hear me? Listen, Miss Diva got married due to COVID. Y'all give it up 2 years. First marriage, goddammit. Goddamn right, he came out of Detroit too. These get away with a lot of shit. How many men in here with good tail? Raise your hand. Ain't but two of you motherfuckers in here.
Wait, I almost raised.
Look here, huh? I'm just saying, when you got that good shit, did you ever see a motherfucker try to quit to good tail? That motherfucker be like, Diva, I'm gonna give you another chance. I know, motherfucker, you will. I'm gonna tell y'all something. Now, y'all men run around here, where that J-Law motherfucker at? Let me tell y'all this. You motherfuckers run around here with that dick. When that dick go out, you can't boss no bitch. Just hand the wallet over to the bitch. Talking that bullshit. Oh, y'all, you didn't know when your dick go out. You just get the wallet on like this and shit. Bring the wallet, motherfucker. Now, before I got married, I would have told one of you motherfuckers, tell your daddy, your uncle, it costs to get this motherfucker. Ain't nothing free on me, dog. Now, I'm from the D. We charge like a motherfucker. You hear me? And Mr. Law talking shit. You got to buy wigs and shit, motherfucker. I don't fuck around for free. You know, look at this motherfucker back there laughing. You done cracked on the Diva two-tone wig. I just got this motherfucker, and you done cracked on me, motherfucker. I'm a bald head bitch, but you know with that jalapeno shit going on, I don't give a fuck. My husband say, I didn't marry you for no hair. I know you didn't, motherfucker. You married me for the snappers, you motherfucker, you. Look here, y'all. She right. I've been up since 5. I'm a boss at work. Ain't nothing like being a motherfucking boss if you got a couple of slow people, which I ain't got nothing against them. But them motherfucking slow people get on your nerve when they slow and try to be slick. Don't be slow and slick, motherfucker. All right, the motherfucker ain't that damn slow. I said, the female came up and asked you for some money. I said, did you even look at the coochie? He said, no. I said, don't get that bitch or die, stupid. Miss Diva, why you sell that? When I'm tired of motherfucker getting tricked out all this goddamn money every Friday. Now, goddamn it, listen.
Can you play me some Whitney? Come on now.
Yeah, I got you.
This is Vegas, baby. Let's do this. I need to feel some energy in this room. I'm from Cali.
You know all the way up from Cali.
That's right. You know Whitney Houston. Yeah. Let's hear some Whitney. That's what I get. All right, party. Show, but there will be many more in Las Vegas. I've been doing comedy for 11 years.
Oh!
Give it up. Is Doughboy still here?
No.
Oh, damn. I was going to take him to Denny's. I have an AARP card and everything. I was going to get him some stacks, you know? I have performed probably in every major club in Los Angeles. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you. So happy to be here in Vegas. Happy to be here. Thank you, Brenda. Shout out to Brenda and all the talent here tonight. That's right. Although I have to say I was a little concerned coming in. You know, they searched me and had a metal detector. I don't know what the fuck's going on in here. I don't know if it's a Zoom meeting or a comedy club or somebody's backyard. I don't know what to expect, you know? But it's all good. It's all good. Again, new to Vegas, but I did hear on the news that we have a brand new governor, Mr. Joe Lombardo. Give it up for Joe Lombardo. I have no idea who he is. All right. But I do know this. He's Italian.
Yeah.
Capiche?
Capiche.
Good man, I'm sure. He reminds me of my dad. If he's anything like my father, I feel 100% safer right now.
Yeah.
100%, because I know Italian fathers, he's out running plates right now in the parking lot, so I'm good, I'm safe.
And I get that up, man. And I want to tell you ladies, I appreciate y'all. You know what I'm saying? Every last woman in here, I want to thank you personally from the men's delegation, even if they hadn't said it. I want to thank you personally, because without you strong women, some of these men in here would have no place to live. So I want to thank you again. Because I know that nigga ain't thanked you. That nigga ain't said thank you, bitch. You still waiting on your rent money. The first is paid. This nigga out there partying and shit. Nigga, rent due Monday, nigga.
Hey.
Y'all make sure y'all pay that DJ. He getting his money worth tonight. That nigga play music while you telling jokes. This nigga's doing the most. Can you hear me? Hey, bartender, fill me up. Let me get one of these high-ass drinks they was talking about. This shit, this drink, nigga, damn near high as my spirit flight. If I get two of these, nigga, that's a flight to the back. I be done drunk my flight up. Nigga, how you do that? Nigga on the phone. What happened? I got stranded in Vegas. What happened? I was at the patio buying drinks. Hey. Spent all my little money up. I got to save something for the hoes, nigga. You know, you come to Vegas, you got to get a hoe. You ain't in Vegas if you ain't had no hooker, nigga. I ain't gonna lie, I ain't even know. You know what I'm saying? Nigga came outside one day. I'm at the casino. You know what I'm saying? I had got booked with, what's the brother name? We was at the Sahara. Eddie Griffin. I got booked over there, did a show with Eddie Griffin. They gave me a room and everything, and I go to the bar. It's a female, pretty as hell. She's sitting at the bar by herself. And you know me being a gentleman, nigga, I just got some money, nigga. I'm in the bar myself. Got a fresh ass room up here in the Sahara. I'm feeling good, nigga. I go right up to her. What's up, baby? You good? You want a drink? All right, we sitting there. She said, yep, I get my drink. Well, how you doing? She said, look, I don't do all this talking now. I charge for hours. I said, hours? Hours? What the hours is? This bitch start talking about if I go up in your room, first of all, ma'am, you said the word hours. You ain't coming up in my goddamn room. I don't know you. I just bought you a drink. I offered you some drink, not some dick. Ladies, let that be known. I know it's a new generation, ladies. Just because a man say you look good don't mean he offering you no dick, boo-boo. A brother could say you look good without offering you no dick. Could you look good? Like, look at this brother right here. That's your girl? This motherfucker's a boxer. He got to fight every goddamn day, nigga. You goddamn right. When you, nigga, I'm telling you, this is the strongest man in here. When your woman is that tall, that goddamn thick, and look that good, this nigga stressing. Because he knows when he walk in the building, all eyes on her. And he gotta accept that shit like a man. Oh, nigga, you think he like it? Hell no. But he know he better not fuck up her mood because he wants some pussy tonight, nigga. Hey, every man in this motherfucker wants some pussy, nigga. You see the nigga with the suit on, Mr. Suit? You think he don't want no pussy? Bitch, you come fresh up out that suit trying to fuck on you. That nigga take that little bow tie off, choking the shit out of his motherfucker neck. That nigga rang out all the curls in his head, bitch. Trying to hit that pussy.
True shit.
That pussy. Hell yeah, pussy run the world. That nigga still laughing. It's running him like a motherfucker now. That nigga got old pussy juice on his dick right now. You know you a nasty motherfucker. You know you just fuck up and you just pull your pants up. All right, I'll catch you later. Nigga be like, shit, I ain't getting no more pussy today. I'm good. Hell yeah. Like I said, I'm from Olin, California, man. I'm going to throw something at y'all. I'm going to see if y'all can throw it back. I tell black people everywhere. I travel around the country doing comedy, and I say that we the same everywhere. So I'm going to throw something at you. I'm going to see if you can throw it back. What's my favorite word?
Bitch.
Why you got to say it like so?
Bitch.
Yep, you niggas ratchet than the motherfucker. Y'all know this little building owned by Mexicans. It was a piñata in the bathroom, nigga. That's how I knew. You had to bust a piñata so you could take a piss. Goddamn. Ooh, I got to hear him get back to California. This shit ain't cool, nigga. I gotta bust a piñata before I take a piss. Jorge at the door, he feeling on a nigga like a motherfucker, too. He like, what's this? I said, my dick, motherfucker. He said, oh, I thought it was a pistola, pistola. He starts speaking to me in Spanish. I'm like, no say, no say. Cállate! Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Have me y'all a favor about that TikTok bullshit. TikTok! TikTok, I ain't gonna lie. TikTok is crazy because You ain't got to fuck with TikTok, but everybody else around you fuck with TikTok. Nigga, the kids, the female. My woman last week told me, she said, I want you to do this Beyonce TikTok with me. I told her, hell no. I ain't that type of brother. Later on that night, I wanted some pussy. She said, hell no. I ain't that type of sister. I said, why? Because you didn't do the Beyonce TikTok with me. Nigga, I was up 2 minutes later. I don't know no steps, but I wanted that pussy. Pussy make the world go round. Shit. I want to see where I'm at again. Let me see, I'm going to throw something at you so you can throw it back. My grandma, she from Louisiana. That's how I was raised by her. Granddaddy from Chicago, Southside. She taught me this. Like I said, I believe we are family, man. It's just coming to you. I think we are family. And you probably was raised like I was raised. So I throw something else at you. I'm going to see if you can throw it back. If somebody hits you, you? Well, why y'all ain't tell that shit to Chris Rock? Why y'all ain't tell Chris Rock that shit? He can't be black letting motherfucker walk up in this no flies. So every dark skinned nigga, when he born, he get a memo that say don't let no light skinned or white people slap you, nigga. He slapped with categories out that nigga, man. You seen that shit? Pow! That motherfucker talking about, oh shit, best actress. Hold up, nigga. That shit was crazy, man. Every man know that, man. We could have a cool little fade, you feel me? We could punch him. You could beat my ass. But I live in the top tomorrow, nigga. You know what I'm saying? I fought. But if you slap me, I don't do shit. I'm a bitch ass nigga, man. That's what it is. Oh, and you think she gonna stay with him if he let somebody slap him? Hell no. And then he can't talk shit to her no more either. If he do, and I don't think that brother do, but if he did, he couldn't talk shit to her no more. It'll be like, all right, check this out. Take your ass upstairs. I don't want to hear shit. She gonna look back. She gonna say, you didn't tell that nigga take his ass upstairs. Well, he fired on your motherfucking ass at the patio. Tapatio, patio, it's all the same, niggas. It's Spanish. Oh, what's that, the new video or the lighter? What's that?
You are live on
Roku. Oh, damn, y'all ain't paying a nigga and recording my shit? These gangsters. Nah, I'm just messing with you. Well, they a drunker nigga dry out here in Vegas, nigga. I done caught a flight. I done bought two $80 drinks. Shit, I don't know how I'm gonna get back. Security. I'm about to file the nigga, just go to jail. Nigga, extradite me, nigga. Give me a free trip back to Cali. Oh, man. I like this, though, man. Like I say, fellas, y'all got to pay attention to the women, man. Love your woman. Love the ladies, man. Pay attention to the ladies. See, for a lot of you fellas, you motherfuckers fail because you don't pay attention to the woman. You so worried about yourself that you forget about her. First thing I want you to do is pay attention to a woman, what she likes. Pay attention to her likes. So you connect right there. If she like hair, nigga, get the bitch some bundles, nigga. You get them $300-$450, nigga, if you go to the cheap spot. But if she really got some requirements, you gonna have to kick out about $800 for that hair. And you know it's the good hair, because, nigga, when it's the good hair, they don't get rid of it hella fast. You go in the bathroom, well, I got a piss, you wake up, she in there brushing this motherfucker. She done shampooed the wig, nigga. That bitch, you put conditioner on the wig? She got that motherfucker hanging up like wet socks. Nigga, you like, what the fuck you did? You better have target practice. There's an intruder in here. Hell yeah, look at them wigs, man. And you gotta pay attention. Like, if you see a woman, fellas, and she in the bathroom, and she got like a spritz bottle, and she's scrunching it, shh, 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 and she keep combing, shh, shh, player, that's the wet and wavy, nigga. Trying to get it to wave up with the wetness.
Not the silky smooth.
Yeah! And if she got her hair freshly braided and some singles, cornrows or something, nigga, she about to go on vacation or she just got back. You better watch your woman. When she braid her hair, that bitch gone. If she get her hair that new braid style, you just wait. Because she going to say, you know, me and my girls, we about to go on a trip. Girls trip, what? Hell no, I'm going to take them braids down one by one, dude. I don't give a fuck if they singles. Hell yeah, man. Pay attention. I seen a sister in here right now. You see that in the back? Nigga, that's a 1B.
He said,
I seen an ombre in this bitch too, though, nigga. Ombre, nigga. An ombre, fellas, if you don't know, is when the hair is one color up top and it turn another color. That's an ombre. Like, you see little mama right here? You see her haircut? That ain't no true ombre, but that's an ombre. She looked that motherfucker. You couldn't tell her shit when she got that haircut. Ooh, ain't nothing like a black woman with a new hairstyle. They got a new walk, nigga. Hip well in. She gliding to work, nigga. She gliding to work. Can't tell her shit. Serious, man. Fellas, I'm gonna tell you like this, man, before I get up out of here. Stand on your own 10 toes, man. I'll leave y'all with three things. First thing I'll leave you with is this. If you driving a woman's car, and your name ain't on shit. Woo! Brother, you in a stolen vehicle. You laying down the law tonight. Now look, I always encourage my brothers, and I don't talk down on nobody, but sometimes as a black man, systematic racism, you gotta look up to see the bottom just so you can get a good start. You might need some help. Now if you go live with a woman, and you find out once again that your name ain't on nothing, player, let me tell you, that's not your woman. Nigga, that's your landlord. My brother, he found out last week he was a tenant. Put his ass right out. The nigga called me. I said, first of all, brother, my name is not Tyrone. But she told him, help him come get his shit. I go get my brother, this motherfucker, he ain't got nothing but one, he got two garbage bags and a TV, nigga. He got two garbage bags and a flat screen. And I'm looking like, where's you taking this flat screen, nigga? You could have just left that. The TV belong in the house. Nigga, you in transit right now. You don't know where you going. Hell yeah, Ma's like, that's crazy. I had to tell my brother that shit, man. My grandpa, man, my granddaddy, my grandmama, I think I got my sense of humor from her and my mother. Cause my grandma, she talked hella shit to my granddaddy. Like I said, he was Chicago, he talked big shit. He didn't give a fuck. One day he told her, he said, bitch, your wig stink. We laughing. We like, nigga, granny wig stink, nigga. Granny said, oh, is that right? She said, I had to tell you last night, but I'm gonna tell you right now. She said, nigga, your dick don't work. I want you to stop calling it a dick. He said, what you want me to call it? She said, nigga, your dick don't work. That's a titty in your pants. Damn. With an inverted nipple.
Damn.
I didn't understand what that meant at the age I was, but nigga, 10 years later, I was dying. Nigga, I said, wow. She called that nigga dick a titty, nigga. Grandma had jokes.
$100K in my dough stash, I'm sitting tall and y'all broke cash. My stack sticking.